Shops lately, you must have come across made in China products which were priced so inexpensively that you wondered how does China manufacture things so cheap. In this video, we shall give you the 15 real reasons why China is able to make and deliver goods at such a low price and still make profits. So keep watching and please like this video and subscribe to our channel. First reason China makes goods at such low prices is practice makes perfect. In his 2018 article in Forbes magazine, Willy Shi, a Harvard Business School professor and co-author of the book Producing Prosperity: Why America Needs a Manufacturing Renaissance, says that there are tremendous benefits of learning by doing. The high volume of demand drives down the Chinese manufacturers on the learning curve and allows them to keep driving their cost down. They have improved their processes so much and so rapidly that they now enjoy the lowest possible cost. The second reason is high savings in shipping costs. The United Nations has an agency called Universal Postal Union or UPU. This agency establishes the international shipping rates, also known as international terminal dues. In doing so, it categorizes its member countries into two groups, target countries and transition countries. Target countries such as USA and European Union pay the highest fees, and the transition countries such as China pay lower rates. For example, it may cost around $20 to ship a 2 kg package from one state of US to the another state in the US, say from state of Florida to California. But it may cost only about $5 to receive this package in California from China. Third reason is trade finance practices by China. Chinese banks encourage buyers in other countries to buy from Chinese companies by giving them good payment terms. For example, the buyer company pays a small amount to the Chinese seller and rest of the payment is given to the seller by Chinese banks. Buyer makes the payment later on to the Chinese bank. Cost of late payment by the buyer and risk of non-payment is entirely borne by Chinese banks. This is an indirect way of subsidizing Chinese manufacturers because they are able to avoid trade finance charges or avoid any default risk. There is of course side effect to this policy, which is manifested in China's state-owned banks holding large portfolio of non-performing assets or loans, that is NPLs or NPAs. The fourth reason is that China has become among the top countries receiving foreign direct investment or FDI. For last several years, for example, in 2019, China received $140 billion of FDI. India, on the other hand, received only about $49 billion of FDI. FDI provides many competitive advantages. For example, it brings with it the managerial best practices and skills because many FDI financed companies are managed by the foreign talent. FDI is also often linked to improvement of marketing and distribution skills of the workforce. Take example of China's textile industry. China has been the largest purchaser of both new looms and equipment in recent years. Most of this purchase has been paid for by the FDI. As a result, Chinese textile workers have attained productivity rates as high as those in the US, and hence Chinese manufacturers are able to create output at a lower price. Fifth reason for cheaper exports by China is its dumping strategy. Goal of dumping is to capture the market share or destroy the competition of a given product or commodity. To do this, price of the product or commodity is lowered below the price offered by the competition on a consistent basis. In June of 2020, China lost a WTO dispute with European Union. As a result of this dispute settlement, China's status in WTO will continue to be that of a non-market economy, which will make it easier for other countries to impose higher anti-dumping duties on Chinese goods. Sixth reason. All employees in China are members of All China Federation of Trade Unions, ACFTU. This union is controlled by the Communist Party of China, CCP. Since ACFTU has monopoly over trade unionizing in China, it has been able to control wage rise and labor protest in China. This creates overall a worry-free industrial environment. Seventh reason is that China provides a good ecosystem for manufacturing. This ecosystem helps innovation and entrepreneurship. By ecosystem, we mean presence of ingredients required for factories to thrive, such as land, labor, government policy encouragements, infrastructure, abundance of collaborating factories, suppliers, and customers and customers, education institutions, regulators, distributors, public acceptance of industrialization, public attitude, technical know-how, etc. China has developed several industrial network clusters. These clusters refer to the practice of locating all or most of the key enterprises in an industry's supply chain to close geography to each other. For example, Chinese cities of Foshan and Shunde are major hubs for appliances such as washing machine, microwave ovens, and refrigerators. Eighth reason is Chinese government's fiscal policies. For example, China is one of many countries which have a value-added tax VAT system. VAT is a tax levied only on the value added to a product. In China, companies receive VAT refund from Chinese government for the goods they export. Practically, it means there is little or no tax paid by Chinese manufacturers for the goods they export. Manufacturers also benefit from subsidized rent or cheap or free land in China. The ninth reason is economies of scale. In microeconomics, economy of scale refers to the cost advantages that a manufacturer gets due to when it manufactures large quantity of output. In other words, economies of scale means lower per unit fixed cost when greater quantity of output is produced. Chinese manufacturers produce their goods in very large quantities. As a result, their fixed cost is spread over a large number of units and thus the average cost of output is much lower. Tenth reason is better bargaining power of Chinese manufacturers. Because Chinese manufacturers produce output in large quantities, they need raw materials in large quantities. This gives them tremendous power to bargain lower prices of input raw material from their suppliers. For the 11th reason, consider this. When manufacturers produce large quantities, where do they sell all these goods? Unless a manufacturer is able to sell, it will go out of business. Answer to this question is Alibaba, which is a Chinese e-commerce giant. Alibaba sells its goods to wholesalers and retailers across the world, thus opening up the large global market to even small manufacturers in China. 12th reason is low cost of the skilled labor. Direct labor cost includes salary, bonus, overtime payments. Indirect labor cost includes overheads such as labor uniforms, restrooms, air conditioning, health and safety costs, etc. In China, cost of skilled labor, which is sum of direct and indirect labor cost, is still much lower than that of many other countries. This low labor cost translates into lower prices of the manufactured goods. 13th reason is poor enforcement of environmental laws and disregard of international intellectual property rights. This has helped China manufacture many goods across many product lines. 14th reason is better infrastructure in China. In many developing countries, industry does not even get 24/7 electricity and water. In China, on the other hand, there are very good roads and railways and other infrastructure. This access to good roads and railways reduces transportation time and cost. China also has very good air and ship connectivity with the rest of the world, which enables smooth flow of made in China goods across the globe. 15th reason is currency manipulation by China. Instead of allowing market demand and supply to decide price of Chinese currency, China's central bank keeps its prices lower so that its exports remain cheaper. In August 2019, Chinese currency dropped to historic lows and the US President Mr. Trump accused China of currency manipulation.